Here's a nice Pythagorean theorem question for us that will involve factoring in order to solve. Find the lengths of the sides of a right triangle. So we have a right triangle. Here's my triangle over here. I've got sides A, B, C, where C is the hypotenuse. And it says the hypotenuse is 10 centimeters longer than the shorter leg and 5 centimeters longer than the longer leg. Now, right off the bat, be careful because it's saying the hypotenuse is, and the hypotenuse is. So it's really comparing the hypotenuse to the shorter leg and the longer leg. So what I want to do is flip it around. So rather than saying hypotenuse is 10 centimeters longer than the shorter, I want to flip this around and say shorter is equal to hypotenuse minus 10. Same thing over here. Rather than saying hypotenuse is 5 longer than the longer leg, I want to flip this around and say longer is equal to the hypotenuse minus 5. So that being said, going back to the Pythagorean theorem, I can say a squared plus b squared equals c squared. And now all I have to do is plug in these two equations that we just found out. Before we do that, remember, I'm always going to be looking for some kind of let statement. What is x? So in this case, we're going to say let x equal the length of the hypotenuse. And then let's plug things in. So A is equal to one leg, and it doesn't really matter which one. So I'm going to say, I shouldn't say H. I should say X. Let's erase this. I should really say X minus 5 rather than hypotenuse minus 5 squared plus the quantity of X minus 10 squared is equal to X squared. Remember, the hypotenuse is also squared. So foiling these two expressions out, or distributing these two expressions out, I will get x squared minus 10x plus 25. The next one, I will get x squared minus 20x plus 100 equals x squared. Combine some like terms, and what we will get is we'll get 2x squared minus 30x plus 125 equals x squared. Now remember, when solving a quadratic equation, the first thing we have to do is get it equal to zero. So subtract x squared from both sides, and when I do that, we'll get x squared minus 30x plus 125 on the left-hand side is equal to zero. And last but not least, what we have to do is we have to factor and solve. Well, maybe not last, but at least one of the last steps is factor and then solve. Definitely it's going to be x and x. X times x gives us x squared. And now what two numbers multiply together gives us 125? I'm going to guess the numbers 25 and 5. 25 times 5 is 125. And I want a negative 30, so I'm going to say negative 25 and a negative 5. Because negative 25 times a negative 5 gives positive 125. And when I FOIL it out, negative 25 and negative 5 will give us negative 30. Now, if we solve each of these equal to 0, we're going to get x is equal to 25. And we're also going to get x is equal to 5. Now, every once in a while, you've got to stop and say, are these good answers? Well, let's think about this. If x was equal to 5, or if the hypotenuse was equal to 5, what would that tell us about our longer side? If x is really the hypotenuse, or h, 5 minus 5 gives me 0. How can I have a length that's 0 for a triangle? In other words, that is not a good solution. I will let you check this and write out your answer, but make sure you're saying that the lengths of the sides of the triangle are 25, 20, and 15 centimeters.